Rolling cloud in your mist, in my DST of your environment. I'm getting ready to run this thing home. Because I'm going to talk about Exodus, and I'm going to talk about how God's presence was in the mist, M-I-S-T, in a vaporized kind. Most of us can relate to this story. Most of us has heard of the story of God's cloud leading the Israelites during Israel's long trip, which lasted 40 years because they just couldn't get it in the wilderness. The Bible lets us know that the cloud was not God. God was in the cloud. God was in the mist, in the confusion. Now, please, I want you to understand me. The cloud has a dual meaning. God is trying to lead his people to the promised land by means of a mist, which was nothing more or less than a cloud. Let's look at some scriptures real closely. Do you have your Bible? Exodus chapter 13, verses 21 through 22. I'm going to come out of the King James Version. And the Word of God says this: And the Lord went before them by day in a pillar. Notice, it says in, enveloped, in a pillar of a cloud. Didn't say he was the cloud. It says the Lord went before them by day in a pillar of a cloud to lead them the way. By night in a pillar of fire to give them a light to go by day and night. He took not the pillar of the cloud by day, nor the pillar of fire by night from before the people. So God is not a cloud. He was in the cloud. So the people could not see him face to face. To see God face to face meant you would die. He was in the fire, but he was not the fire. He was just in the fire trying to protect and guide his people to a better life. He was in the cloud so that he could protect and guide his people to a better life. Can you really have a family without the Father in the mist? It was the mist of the glory from God that inhabits Mary with the baby boy called Jesus. We know that when people are gathering together in unity and in love, and they are all focused on God, does not God comes into their presence corporally? Does not God comes through the church like a mist, sometimes like a wind? There is glory in the church when the mist of God is amongst us. I really didn't know how I was going to explain this to y'all. To be truthful to you, for years I've taught this teaching, but did not know what I was teaching. It wasn't until today that God opened up my eyes to see that he was to be missed, us in the mist. M-I-D-S-T, us in the M-I-S-T, mist. God wants to be with us, the mist, and within his glory, mist. There are many different ways he does that. However, for the most part, God will come to us and be with us in a mist. He is amidst us within the mist of his glory. Now, that's an encouraging word. It is very important as a family to keep God within the mist, M-I-D-S-T, the environment, to keep his mist, his glory cloud among us in order that our families will be made whole. How do we keep him in the mist? Through prayer. We pray until we feel him. We pray until the room is engulfed with him, until the mist of his Shekinah glory permeates throughout our environment. I remember when my children were small, they would come up in my bedroom. I had my door open, and I'd be up underneath the blankets. And I see their little heads looking through the door, and then they go out the door. Then I see them come back, and they look through the door. And then they go back out the door. And then I see them come up, and their little heads peeping around, looking at me. Then finally, my oldest boy said, Mommy, we feel God's glory in downstairs. And then I woke up, and I told him, because even though the blankets were pulled over my head, it was kind of like a prayer shawl. And even though I was laying in the bed, I was praying. And they could feel the fog, the glory, the cloud in the house. They was all the way downstairs. They was running upstairs. And they couldn't understand what was going on because in all appearances, it looked like I was asleep. And they knew that when they felt that presence, that meant mommy was praying. And they were feeling that presence, but they didn't see me on my knees or hear me crying out. They saw me laying in my bed. And they were like, how can that be? Mommy's not praying. Mommy was praying, and they was feeling the glory. The word mist can mean a thin fog with condensation near the ground. That's the word I wanted to use, condensation. A mist can also mean a thing or a thin layer of condensate vapor. I can't pronounce it today. I could the other day, but I can't pronounce it. But it's a vapor. Condensed. There it is. Now I can say it. Condensed. Like a spirit that can change to water and liquid. The Bible has much to say about water. The mist can become a covering. You can become enveloped in the mist. When the mist comes, you can become tearful. Now I got this question to ask you. When was the last time the Holy Ghost caused you to have a good cry? Turn your Bibles to 2 Peter, 2nd chapter, 17th through 18th verse. And the Word of God says this: these are wells without water, clouds that are carried with a tempest, to whom the mist of darkness is reserved forever. For when they speak great swelling words of vanity, they allure through the lust of the flesh, through much wantonness. Those that were clean escape from them who live in error. These are springs without water and mist, driven by a storm, from whom black darkness has been reserved. For speaking out arrogant words of vanity, they entice by fleshly desires, by sensuality, those who barely escape from the ones who live in error. Verse 19, promising them freedom while they themselves are slaves of corruption. For by what a man is overcome, by this he is enslaved. Verse 20, for if after they have escaped the defilement of the world by the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, they are again entangling them and are overcome, the last state has become worse for them than the first. Can you really have a family without the Father in the midst? When God opened up my eyes to this reality, I was totally surprised. And there's a couple of realities that opened up my eyes, and I got a couple of minutes I want to share with you that really I had to laugh to myself about it when I thought about all the different times the children of Israel had been complaining and were very discontent with Moses for bringing them out to a desert with no means of getting water to drink, with a cloud in front of them. I used to think, God led all those people into the desert with no water. To my surprise, finally, as I was studying this, the Lord said, what do you think that great big old gigantic cloud was for? The Lord said, doesn't water come from a rain cloud? These people had a water tank leading them and didn't ask Moses to pray that God would give them a little rain from the cloud or the mist that they were following. God was inside of it. He wasn't it. He was inside of it to shield them from seeing him, because no man can see him and live. Now I understand. And now I know why the Bible calls us sheep, because sheep may be gentle, but sheep are not very smart. They're kind of dumb. With that big old cloud in front leading them for all those years, you mean to tell me nobody thought to ask in prayer to God to rain on them from that great big old gigantic mist of with a condensed vapor moving in front of them? Well, it's like this. I guess when you're a slave for all them years, you can't finish school. When you're a slave to drugs and alcohol, when you're a slave, you don't know how to ask God for the right thing. You can't see the blessing, even though the blessing may be right in front of you. You're crying out to God, you're murmuring, you're complaining. The cloud is right in front of you. The cloud is there. It's in your mist, M-I-D-S-T, and God is within the mist. He's within what it is that you need, M-I-S-T. God wasn't the condensed vapor. He was inside of it. Read all of Exodus chapter 17. The Israelites always was complaining about something. This is why God gave them more water out of a rock. He was telling them something. They were a bunch of hard, complicated people to try to please. You got a big old mist of condensed vapor moving in front of them, in front of you, and you are complaining you got no water. God was their source. But they were not looking at it that way. You got a big cloud leading you. We know that God could have led them 1 trillion different ways, but he decided to lead them by a cloud, a mist, because he knew that the people would need water, but he wanted them to get the water from him. These were some blind people, and there's some that way today. They were always complaining, murmuring one against one another, fighting with one another. You think out of 3 million people, somebody would have came up with the idea that maybe we should pray. There is a cloud there. Won't we see if that cloud can rain? He tried, but he gave them what they wanted. God wanted them to have uncontaminated, unending, fresh water supply to drink, like the manna he tried to give them. But they didn't want it. They wanted flesh. They wanted quail. So he gave it to them till it came out of their nose. And to wash it down, God gave them water out of a hard rock. After all, that's what they wanted. These people could not see that God's mist, his glory cloud, was in the midst of their environment, M-I-D-S, that all they need was there in his glory cloud. All they had to do was pray and usher the glory cloud. That's all they had to do. The water was already there. He did not send them out there to go without water. He was their source. He was what would